Second unit, planning. What is mean by planning? Planning is nothing but it means to deciding or forecasting about futures. Okay. In second unit, we have to see about what is mean by planning. Planning is nothing but is deciding in advance. We already see it's deciding in advance what to do, how to do, and when to do, and whom to do. So it is planning about what kind of manufacture we have to do, what kind of sources we have to purchase. So that type of planning is it can be decided in advance. So that is called as planning. Okay, planning is it is a future courses of action, choosing a future courses of actions. So next one is nature of planning. What is mean by nature of planning? Planning is it's completely depends upon future goals. So it is a planning is a goal oriented one. And another point is it is a primary functions for each and every activities. And third point is planning is all pervasive functions. Pervasive functions we all know it is a pervasive functions. And another one is it is a continuous process. Yeah, every day we have to plan something about anything else we have to plan and to make a formulations to do work. Okay, so it is a continuous process and also it's forecasting a future. So it is called forward looking planning. Okay, and another one is planning involves choice. Yeah, now number of choice in front of us we have to pick out any one of the planning any one of the choice and to make a and to have to make a plan about that. Okay, so it is a choosing one. Okay, another one is it is directed towards efficiency. Yeah, every activity should be implemented and to forward and to work efficiently and effectively. Okay. So next one is process of planning. What is mean by process of planning? Planning, first one is we have to plan about anything. We pick out number of alternatives in front of us. We have to select to anyone and to formulate everything. Okay. For first step is to define the task. What is our task to be clearly defined? Another one is to identify the resources. First one is defining a task is completed. We have to find out the available sources. What are the sources we have to make it? So that is the second step to identify the resources. Okay. Another one is third step is to considering alternatives. Yeah. Once we have to decide one task, we have to see about their alternative also. So that is called as consideration of alternatives and have to create the planning. After that, the fourth step is to create a plan and have to work the plan. Work the plan means to be implemented in practices. In practices, that is such is called as work the plan. Another one is evaluating. After once we have to implement their work, what we have to plan to be in practice and have to evaluate every activities should be followed in our derived process. So that is called as evaluation. Okay. So another one is importance of planning. Why planning is important for every activities? So planning is important causes to focus our future events, to predict the future events. We have to decrease our obstacles to attain our task. So it is a main foremost causes for planning. So first one is focuses attention and objectives and result. So making a focus on our objectives and how to attain a clearly result and how to attain our goals. So that is the main thing to focus the objectives. Okay. Another one is reduce uncertainties. We already see it is a future predictions. So we have to reduce the uncertainty and the risk. Risk depends upon their work. So it helps to reduce the uncertainty risk also. Another one is provide a sense of directions. Yeah. Every planning create a good way, a good path to attain our destination. destination. So it is provide a sense of directions. Okay. Another one is encourages. Encourages means it is a innovation and creativity. It's completely innovation and creativity upon depends upon their planning. Okay. It's provide it encouraging the new ideas and new creativity things to do in practice. So okay. Next one is helps in coordination. Yeah, every activity should be planned or derived in earlier. We have to maintain a better coordination from all of them. So that is, it helps to provide in coordinations. Another one is guidelines. Yeah, proper guidelines. It gives a correct time and correct time of instruction to all of them. Okay, it gives our guides to make a good decision at a time. So another last point is it provide efficiency in operations. Yeah, better efficiency in our activities. So it is the main causes of importance of planning. And what are the limitations in planning? Yeah, each and every activity should be pre-planned. So every activities cannot be pre-planned correctly, cannot predict our futures correctly. So that is the first one is lack of accurate information about the future events. So first limitation is that lack of accurate information. Another thing is time and cost. Yeah, every activity should make a proper planning. It will take a times and also for a cost also. So second one is resistant to change. Yeah, no one can forecast our future. So if we faced any problems, it can be to change, changing one. Okay. Another one is lack of ability to plan. No one is better completely forecast our future. So that is the lack of ability to plan and false sense of security. Yeah, no more security for our planning, because we estimate their target to work. It can be or cannot be correct one. So sense of security also very limitations, and under the economic consideration also unpredictable one. So environmental consideration also main limitation for planning. So next topic is the principles of planning. Principles of planning. What are the principles for planning? First one principle is to contributions to the objectives. Main forecasting, it depends upon our objectives. So it is the first foremost point for planning. Okay, another one is principles, efficiency of planning. What are the principles means? To plan efficiently. So that is the second point. So planning principle is completely depends upon our objectives, and it completely depends upon our efficiency and primary. What are the primary things to make a plan? So that also my main principles. Another one is time, cost, and everything. Okay, it is clear. So another thing is types of planning. What are the types of planning? Planning can be classified into three types. First one is corporate planning, and next one is divisional planning, divisional or functional planning, and grouping plan, group of planning. So what is mean by group? Group or sectional planning. It's nothing but group means separate group within the department or the divisions. They have one plan to accomplish their work. Okay. Another one is departmental or divisional planning. Departmental plan means it's from various department have to make a some such kind of planning about their work. So another one is corporate planning. Corporate planning is nothing but it's from top management to planning about whole company what have to do in futures. So that's about the corporate planning. Yeah, thank you. It is clear for all. Yeah, okay. Planning, today we have to see about, we had to see what is planning and what are the natures depends upon their planning and the principles of planning and types of planning. So today we had complete second unit planning. Okay, thank you.